I got to the nitty-gritty part. The part where I want to say to you all how proud and fantastic I'm actually feeling at this moment in time. I would finally like to thank my wife. I just want to say thank you. If she would like to stand up, because I want to read this to her properly. I would like to say a massive thank you to you for always being here, making me happy, marrying me. I knew you were the right one from day one. I do apologize. The printer was jammed. I couldn't imagine life without you. I would also like to say thank you for giving me the two most important people in my life, Ellie Mae and Alfie. You're a great man to them. We love you very much. You're the rock of our relationship and my best friend. I love you more than words can say. Well, I am a man of very few words, as you know. It took me 6 weeks to write this speech, by the way. I was terribly nervous about this part. It's the most people I've ever spoken in front of. But I just want to say to you, Tanya, thank you for everything. You really have been the best thing that has ever happened to me, and I cannot wait to grow old with you. I love you more and more each day. You make my heart skip a beat. For those of you who don't know, us men have dreams of our wedding day when we were younger. They might not be the same as you women, about dresses, big churches, but nevertheless, we do have dreams. When I was younger, my dream was to marry a beautiful woman and be happy for the rest of our lives and have a family. Tanya, you have made that wish come true today. This is what I wanted from a marriage. When I met Tanya, I knew. We're on the last page. I knew that she was different. She made me laugh in many different ways. And that feeling of happiness I get when I'm around you cannot be described. I love you always, Tanya. There are so many good times that Tanya and I have enjoyed together. Days out, holidays, and nights out with friends and family. But like all couples, we have had our lows. Falling outs. Arguments between ourselves on more than one occasion. Tanya always wins. I'll stick to that. But all these factors have made us who we are today. A strong couple who work brilliant together and cannot wait to see what the future brings for us. Finally, I would like to say a massive thank you to everyone that's here today for celebrating with us today. For myself and this, I can't even describe how I feel about saying this, and my beautiful wife, Tanya. Thank you all very much.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm Cavan welcome to you all here in the beautiful surroundings here of the Slieve Russell Hotel. Both Veronica and I are delighted to welcome Daniel into the Harvey family. And although he has been a big part of our family for some time now, so much so that at times I do feel like I have a second shadow. That's how close we've become. And so the planning and the preparations began. But I'd have to say, without Tanya's foresight, tenacity, and at times downright Harvey stubbornness, not to mention our iPhone, we could all be still here waiting for Daniel to send out the wedding invitations. Thank you.
So it's with my whole heart I take you as my husband, acknowledging and accepting your faults as you do mine. I promise to be faithful and to support you and to always make our family's love and happiness a priority. So I give you this ring as a symbol of my love for you today and always.
I now declare you to be husband and wife. Daniel, you make Esha proud.
We brought pictures of our own parents on their wedding day, and Peggy especially. I know Daniel's family has appreciated seeing Peggy up there today. We did incorporate it into the bridal bouquet. I know some people copped it, some people didn't, but fate brought her here and she fell off my bouquet because she wanted to land in Daniel's pocket early in the day. So he has been carrying his mother around in his pocket for the whole day since it fell off. So I think she's actually where she wants to be, needless to say.